Hello, everyone. Hope your Tuesday is spooky and fun. My name is Cole.
And I'm Erika. Welcome back to another episode of Studio 21, where you hear the latest gossip, news of upcoming movies and games, and some chilling experiences to get us in the mood for Halloween, which is right around the corner.
Oh, wow, Erika. You're so right. Halloween is less than a week away, and I couldn't be more excited.
Yep, I can't wait to get loaded up on tons of candy. If Halloween on Oakmont doesn't give out, you know, those full-size candy bars, then I'm gonna be real disappointed.
Well, Erika, I sure hope you'll be able to get your sugar rush on. Anyways, I just can't wait to see part two of The Black Swan Inn.
Oh, me too. From the interview with the owner last week, that place sure does sound a little bit haunted. So I'm nervous, but excited to find out more about what might be going on there.
Anyways, I suggest you all get ready for some scares, and I hope you enjoy this spooky episode of Studio 21. Hello, and welcome to this week's episode of Gossip Guru. I'm Cole.
And I'm Erika.
Erika, what is your opinion on Taylor Swift?
Taylor Swift? So, I'm not the biggest fan of Taylor Swift, but here and there, I do hear her songs, so...
You know, I agree. I don't follow her very closely, but I know she's huge. So, and as you may know, she just released her new LP titled Midnights.
It would be hard not to feel like I've seen that everywhere.
Her fans are definitely very dedicated to her music. There are some fans who are especially passionate about her, mainly in reference to elaborate theories about her personal life.
Oh, so like paparazzi dating rumors?
There's been a considerable amount of those theories surrounding her, most notably her possible relationship with Diana Agron, which I mean more like analyzing song lyrics and creating theories based off supposedly hidden meanings in her songs.
Oh, I know what you mean. The things where people think she's not over an ex or something because of one song.
Well, no, okay, let's play a game. I'm going to list off a few song titles and you guess what the fan theory is about them. Here's the list in chronological order. Welcome to New York, Style, I Know Places, Out of the Woods, Ever Since New York, and Two Ghosts.
Maybe some sort of crime scene took place, like a big murder?
Actually, you're not too far off. The theory is that when Swift dated Harry Styles in 2012, they accidentally committed vehicular manslaughter.
Oh, well, that's surely a theory.
I personally love the idea that she accidentally ended someone's life and then proceeded to be just like, this would make a great song. And do that six times? I mean, imagine a lawyer in the court proceedings presenting evidence to the judge and it's just like, are we out of the woods yet? Are we out of the woods yet? Are we out of the woods yet?
Your Honor, Your Honor, what my client cook? Funnily enough, my story has Taylor Swift in it as well. There's an account on Twitter called Celeb Jets. On that account, they basically show like the records of private jets as well, which is public information, but celebrities don't really like it because, you know, they're all original. This account gained notoriety for gaining trust from people of getting the records of the jets. And
Well, and Swift's flight records were on there as well, right?
Yeah, absolutely. This account posts anywhere from 20 to 40 times a day.
Okay. So those short flights that I saw online about Taylor Swift. So with people buying a lot of jets, that makes a lot of sense, especially with people buying jets for themselves and then putting it in perspective like that is kind of crazy. So Taylor Swift takes short flights or something, right?
As a matter of fact, she is the biggest offender. Her annual carbon dioxide emissions are around 8,000 tons. For reference, the average amount of person doesn't have as much. They only produce 14 tons of carbon dioxide emissions per year. Hmm. So Swift is producing, guess what, 570 times the average emission rate.
That sucks. But I'm sure that JoJo Siwa wouldn't do this. Did you see that she dressed up as Draco Malfoy? It looked so good. As a matter of fact, it inspired me so that I am happy to say my Halloween costume this year will be me dressed as JoJo Siwa, dressed as Draco Malfoy. I expect that is going to make waves next Monday.
Oh, I'm so sure.
Oh, yeah, but the stuff with jets, I guess I should invest in some metal straws and help the climate. Well, that's all we have this week. I'm Cole.
And I'm Erika. Now, enjoy our music video of the Leaf, Ghosts and Stuff by Denmall 5.
Hello and welcome to Release Day. I'm Daphne Tett.
And I'm Naked Snake.
This week on Release Day, we're going to try something different. Instead, we're going to talk about a music album. K-pop girl group Le Sserafim released their newest EP, Anti-Fragile, just last week on October 16th. This is the group's second release and their first as a group of five.
The album features five songs. The Hydra is an ambient song, introducing the album with the members speaking Korean, Japanese, and English. The title track, aptly named Anti-Fragile, is a Latin hip-hop inspired track with impossibly catchy lyrics. Impurities is a chill song with lots of synths. No Celestial is a rock track that's meant for jamming out to. And the final song, Good Parts, is a calming and inspirational song with lyrics about loving yourself.
I wouldn't consider myself a Le Sserafim stan, but this album is special to me. The title track is stuck in my head, and the B-sides are all memorable, but the thing I like most is the message. If you look at the album cover, you see it looks like kintsugi, a Japanese art where broken pottery is fixed with gold paste to draw attention to the cracks. And I think that, combined with the album title and lyrics, gives the message that we need to love ourselves, flaws and all, and I think that's beautiful.
Now, I don't really know much about K-pop. My expertise in foreign music extends about as far as Japanese music that I can't understand, mostly from movies, shows, games I like Metal Gear. But hey, if the music is as good as the Korean films I've seen, then I'm sure it's great.
Believe me, you don't need to understand Korean to understand Entity Fragile Fragile. And it's available on Spotify, YouTube Music, Pandora, and Deezer, and physical copies are also available for sale.
For this week's movie, we'll be talking about the recently released slasher horror film, Halloween Ends.
Halloween Ends is the third and final film of the Halloween Soft Reboot trilogy. This film follows Halloween 2018 and Halloween Kills, which was released last year. This movie is being touted as the last Halloween film in the franchise.
This film, to put it bluntly, is obscenely bad. Halloween 2018 was a pretty serious, solid movie that's fun was derived from how well it handled itself. Halloween Kills was quite bad, but was so ridiculous that it was funny and still fun. Halloween Ends, however, is still bad, but takes itself way too seriously, essentially draining the film of fun. The iconic killer of these films, Michael Myers, if I'm being generous, has probably less than 10 minutes of screen time, and kills less people than he did in the original 1978 film. All of the named and important characters who died in the last two films are virtually never mentioned, and their deaths, for the most part, have negligible consequences. The film primarily hinges on a cringeworthy and boring romance that leads nowhere. Possibly the worst of it comes from the mixed and inconsistent characterization of the film's main character, Laurie Strode.
Dude, I cannot do horror. It's either poorly made and doesn't do a good job of scaring anyone, or it does its job a little too well and I never want to see it again. Trust me, ever since I saw Lady in Black 5 years ago, I've tried to stay away from the genre. This, to me, looks like just another horror movie. Darkness, jump scares, killing people, screams, the dead body in the pool enough was enough to drive me away from the movie. With a title like Halloween Ends, this better be the last one.
I couldn't agree more. You should definitely skip this movie. Just stick with the original film, which is legitimately great, and maybe the first one of the trilogy if you really want to.
Well, that's all we have this week on release date. I'm Daphne.
And now I'm Big Boss. See you all again next week, but stay tuned for part two of the Black Swan Inn, where some of our team set out on a spooky paranormal investigation.
Is this Sebastian?
Seems like it is.
He likes you.
I guess so.
The camera.
Oh no.
Oh boy. Do you not like being recorded?
Oh my gosh!
Yeah, we're going to the gazebo and it smells like chicken poop.
Is there a lot of activity at the gazebo?
We don't know. We're about to find out. I'm gonna get the vibe that there is. I don't know. Earlier the rods were following Lex, so.
I think I'm spiritually intuned.
I think he has some like powers.
Are you willing to talk right now? Can you show us a no?
What's your signal for no? Thank you.
Can you point to where you are?
Are you behind someone?
Can you point to who you're behind? Are you behind Anna?
This is Anna.
They're just watching the camera.
Are you happy? Good.
So right now we are crossing the street from the Black Swan Inn to, this is another piece of property owned by the same owners, but there's a little creek here with a bridge over it, and the owner of the Black Swan Inn told us this story. So there was a woman who was pregnant and her boyfriend actually murdered her by drowning her in this river, and then he took her body to a field and burned it. So we're gonna head to the bridge and just try and be very respectful and see if we can communicate with anyone.
Currently we're on the side of the creek from the property that we're at the Black Swan Inn. Currently there is a spirit that is accepting us to have a conversation with on camera. Are you a woman spirit? That's a bit of a no. It is not a woman spirit.
Okay.
That's cool.
Is there any spirit with us right now?
Hello.
There we go.
Are you willing to have a conversation with us?
Are you willing to have a conversation with us?
Okay, let's try and figure out who it is again.
Oh, yes. Are you willing to be recorded? Are you a woman spirit?
Did you ask him as a mother?
Did you die here?
Did you pass away here?
Okay. Oh. Over there.
Are you at peace? So close.
But no.
Is the other spirit willing to talk to us?
We are here in the milk barn. This is where a lot of activity apparently happens, according to Joanne, the owner. And we did, a spirit did let us know that they are here with us and that they are willing to talk, or I guess I didn't ask that, but they are willing to be videotaped. Are you a woman? Are you Elizabeth? Would you prefer to be called Elizabeth? Would you prefer to be called Emma? Was that you, Elizabeth? Or Emma?
No.
Was that the other spirit?
Was that the other spirit that's here with us? Is it in that corner?
So all of us as a group, we were going to go step out back behind the milking barn and go check out the little wooded area. But as soon as I took a step, I heard rustling in the bushes, like coming closer, and I wasn't even making noise. It was as soon as I touched the ground. Yeah.
Any other experiences?
Mostly like towards the end of our experience. Because like before we went in that room, I was like completely awake, and once we got there, I just got really tired all of a sudden. Mm-hmm. And then towards the end of our experience in that room, when I was like starting to like doze off a little bit, I like came to just a second before I like kind of fell asleep. And I saw like really weird blue light like towards the doorway. And so I really don't know what that was. Could be because I'm tired. I don't think it is because I'm wide awake now. That's all I have to say.
I thought it was really weird that like we all were pretty awake. I don't know. We all were like decently awake and we were walking there like, oh man, that IHOP totally woke us up. But as soon as we got into that room, I felt so exhausted and I was like fighting sleep the whole time.
Yeah.
And like you fell asleep, you dozed off. I literally was like, what is happening? Like I feel so exhausted all of a sudden.
I wasn't tired, I just didn't feel good. I was so uncomfortable the whole time.
Right here.
I still feel
Yeah,
it, right
it was
here.
Like in your heart. Like yeah. At least for me, like it was like in my heart,
my
in my chest.
Was just
yeah.
like knots. I was just not feeling good. And I still
sad.
Have right here, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But like the entire time, like as soon as we stepped in, I was not feeling good. It was before too, when we walked in, I don't feel good in that room.
Yeah. I don't know, mm-hmm. like, yeah, when I was sitting on the couch at first, I was getting, like, backaches, and I was like, oh, it's probably because of my posture, but then I started getting, like, pain on my side, so.
Oh, no. So, can you tell us what we just heard?
Okay. Let me give you the rundown right here, all right?
We're in Elizabeth's
Look at
room.
This. We're all here. Okay. We're all in this... It's a small little room, right?
Tell us whose room it is.
This is Elizabeth. Or she also goes by Emma. But... We did hear something fall. Half of us heard it this way. Half of us heard it that way. Personally, I heard it that way. And it sounded like a chair falling over.
Hmm.
What is it? Hmm?
And tell us, like, what she said happens in here sometimes.
So when the door is closed, which it is, I don't know if you can see these marks right here. The door is, like, it's not level. The floor is not level. So you kind of have to, like, slide the door in there. And you're supposed to hear footsteps, like, running down this hall right here. And it's...
Now that was something. Yeah. We did hear something.
So right as we were filming Lex explaining what was going down, we kept hearing more noises other than the loud initial one. They were quieter, but there was definitely more noises happening. I think it happened about 3 times. One of them happened during the video. I don't know if it picked it up, but we were all getting a little scared. And we pulled the rods out to try and see what was happening, to see if maybe she was upset that the door was closed. But it was giving us really weird answers that we didn't feel good about. And so some of us went to go check in the other room, and one of the closet doors was open. And we have no business in that closet. And so we went back, tried to close it a couple times. It wouldn't close. I think we finally got it closed, right? Or
it's still pretty dope, it just doesn't shut.
Yeah, but all of the dining room chairs from earlier, whenever we were first all sitting there introducing ourselves, you know, they were all a little askew because, you know, all of us are sitting there. They were all perfectly set. Like, I don't know. And we didn't leave it like that. So I think what we heard was the chairs being moved back to their original position. So we took some pictures of the room. If we hear any other noises, we're gonna compare and see what's different.
Mm-hmm.
So, but pretty spooked.
Alright, hi guys. So we made it through the night. The sun is coming up. It is 7:05 a.m. We are just about to start packing up. We just wanted to give you guys our final little update. So for me, I don't know, I came in here a lot more skeptical than I'm leaving, and I was definitely a little spooked. So, yeah. That's all.
Any words, Matthew?
I was also definitely very skeptical before coming here, but now that I've seen like a bunch of first-time experiences like head-on, I can like tell there's definitely something more into this that we all should look into a little bit more. Mm-hmm. Especially when we were in that room and we heard the sounds in the hallway. That was like the biggest tell that something actually does happen.
Yeah, I don't know, I've always been a really big believer of the paranormal, and so, but I've never experienced it like this before, and so I think, I don't know, being at the creek and having it point to the bed of the creek, and also being in the hallway and hearing that sound, like, I think hearing the sound was the biggest thing, because it's just like physical evidence that there is something more.
I mean, there's no question. I mean, I came in here thinking it was kind of just all for a joke and a gag, and there's like little things that do stuff, but I feel like after today and having my skin feel how it was being in certain rooms and my head hurting and my lower back hurting really bad in places that I didn't like, I have to say.
Yeah, it's really freaky stuff. Just kind of like walking into a room and having like your physical body like change how it feels. Just going from being like full energy to like falling asleep 5 seconds later. You know, it's definitely weird.
We finished our investigation. We had quite a lot of things happen. Definitely felt like a lot of heaviness in places like the milk barn, and when we were in Elizabeth's room and we heard all of the noise outside, that like just a wave came over like me and I know some of the other people of like, we just need to leave this space. So it was definitely very interesting. I definitely believe that there are spirits here and that there's a lot of activity going on here. But it was a good investigation, very successful.